Hello and welcome to another plan with me. So in this plan with me, I'm obviously planning for November, and for November I wanted to do a theme that I have had in my head for a very long time, and I was just waiting for the white month to fit it. And this theme is fairy tale. So you might not know this, but I'm actually German, and Germany is a very big fairy tale country, you could say. So we have a lot of tales and also a lot of parks which are fairy tale themed in Germany, and I don't know, just fairy tales are something in my childhood that I very loved. And so I really wanted to do a fairy tale theme, and I think that it is perfect for November, because the month of November is for me very gloomy and dark and like mysterious, and so I thought it would be perfectly fitting for fairy tales. And for this month I used for reference and inspiration actually a book of my childhood, where I always saw these beautiful fairies and drawings, and I was just amazed as a kid. And so I was inspired to do this fairy that you can see right here for my cover page. And so to make it still a lot more fitting for autumn, I chose to go with the colors of autumn, so a lot of red, browns, yellows and oranges you will see in this whole setup, but of course still a lot of greens, because I think with fairy tales in general and just fairies you will see a lot of green, because it's always like cottagecore. It reminds me a lot of the aesthetic cottagecore, so everything is very much nature-based, and so of course I also will add a lot of green. So yeah, for the cover page we have this little fairy that has a spark on her hand, so she's, I don't know, doing magic or something? We don't really know, because we are no fairies. And she's supposed to be in a forest, and so this is the whole style that I'm going for the cover page and yeah, the general look. And so how I did all of this was basically I sat down for a whole day and just sketched everything, because I wanted everything to be very detailed and very perfect, at least in my eyes perfect. And so yeah, I sketched everything, and then I just took a black fineliner and outlined everything, and afterwards I went in with color. So it was a lot of drawing, and this is not a spread or in general a theme I would suggest for anything starting with bullet journaling or who has little time, because this took me like 3 days. Like sketching and drawing everything while filming, it took me 3 days. It was a lot. I had a lot of fun, but I have also, I have to say, I did go a little crazy with the details. You will see also later, because I didn't do like only simple doodles, I drew really. So I really hope that you like that, and yeah, we will see. And here you can also see the colors that I chose that I already talked about. You can see it is supposed to be green, but also still look like autumn. And for the top of the page, I added a lot of gold. I also drew like this old page that might be out of a book, because I wanted to use some old newspaper, because that would look just stunning. But you know, everything's digital now, and no one in my house reads newspaper anymore. So I had to improvise and do it myself, and so I drew it instead of sticking it into the bullet journal, but I think it looks alright. And also for the heading, I chose to write "Once upon a time in November" to make everything feel more like a fairy tale. For the next page, I usually go for only a quote page in my bullet journal, but I think it is such a pity that I have these cover pages, which are always the ones that take me the longest time, and then I rarely see them because they're only the cover and I don't really use them. So this month I chose to do my calendar on the left hand side, so I need my calendar, and when I use my calendar I still get to see my cover page and to have more use and to see it more often, because yeah, I just think that's a little sad that the cover page don't get the recognition it deserves, at least in my opinion. But still, there's a quote, because I couldn't go without a quote, especially in a theme like a fairy tale, you cannot go without a quote. So I chose, "Those who don't believe in magic will never find it." And underneath that I have this mushroom circle, because fairies and everything just scream mushroom circle to me. And just in general, as a child, I was obsessed with mushroom circles. I always hoped to find one and to get inside of it, and maybe a fairy would take me with her or something. That was just silly little me. Yes, I know. But that's why I really wanted to add one into my setup. And there it is. That's also why I think that the whole theme is perfect for November, because mushrooms are something very much that screamed to me fall and autumn. And so yeah, you will see a lot of mushrooms in this setup. Now off to the next two pages. So usually I would add right here my monthly calendar, but because we already did that, I just added like these spaces that I have every month where I track my numbers. Here I like to track my Instagram numbers of the month and also my monthly goals, and I have a little space to write down Instagram ideas because I like to write down what I want to post in the month, because I do a lot of posts that need some planning beforehand, so that's very useful. And under that I always keep my content planner, so this is usually just a space where I can write down what I want to post on what day. So these are stuff that you don't really need if you are not like me on Instagram and post regularly. I post every single day, and so I really really need that to keep on track and just that everything looks good, but it is not very necessary for everyone. The next page is then my habit tracker. Usually I would also have that on another page, but everything is getting a little bit shorter due to the calendar being with the cover page. But for the habit tracker, I chose again to doodle a lot. And when I say a lot, I mean a lot. This took me so freaking long, really. And it's so many mushrooms on this page. I also added some little doodles of fairies. So they're very ugly. Please don't look at them too closely. But I thought from the far you can tell what they are and that they would look cute. But please don't look closely, please. And as you can see, I went with this page like I did with the others. So I just outlined everything that I sketched before with my black fine liners and also with a gold pen. I needed to do that before because this pen needs to dry down. And then afterwards, I was just going in with the black fine liner. And then I colored everything in with the colors that I chose for this theme. And what I also added a lot were dots. So I added them everywhere, and I think they go very well with the fairy tale theme because they look magical or something. I don't know. I don't really know what they're meant to be, but they look very cute. So I just added dots everywhere. And here on the bottom of the page, you can see that I also doodled again a real sized fairy, if you can say it like that, and also some other cute doodles. And on the habit tracker side, I drew like a little Easter eggs, if you can say so, because besides drawing a lot of mushrooms, little fairies and stuff, I also added to the bottom of the page a cat that has mushrooms growing on her back. I think that it looked very very cute. And also on the bottom, but in the middle of the page, we have this shoe, and you might recognize this shoe. It's from a very famous fairy tale that a lot of people know. And you might have guessed it, even though at this point I've not colored it in yet. It is the shoe of Cinderella. And I just thought that it would be like a cute Easter egg, and it wouldn't necessarily mean to me to draw a princess, but everyone knows this shoe very well, and so I just drew the shoe. She lost it in the woods, we don't know, it's just there. And next to that we have a little mushroom house that's maybe from the fairies, maybe they live in there, we don't know either. And these were these little doodles. Now lastly, we have the weekly spread, the first one as always. The other ones are always on my Instagram if you want to see more of this theme. And for this one, I chose to write down November in the same style I did before, and then write underneath "and the tale begins." So as you can see, I'm very dedicated to the fairy tale theme, and I'm doing everything to pursue it right. For the drawings on this page, I chose for one this little house with a lot of mushrooms on top inside of a glass bottle. I have no idea why, it just looked cute and mystical to me and very fitting for a fairy tale month, but I don't know why it would make sense to be in a bottle, but yeah, there it is. And then for the next thing that I drew, I wanted to do this little like tower or castle that was on a cloud, so it's in the sky, of course. And this could be maybe again a home of fairy. So I also chose to doodle again these very little ugly fairies that are flying around it. And it was just based on a sketch that I saw online that I thought would work perfectly here, because it just reminded me of fairy tales and stuff. And so yeah, it is very sketchy, but I think that makes its charm, and also I think it turned out to be very cute. It would have been even cuter if it would be very colorful, but of course I couldn't do that because I have a color theme going on, and you will see. Of course, I will just start with a rough like fine liner sketch, and afterwards I will color it, and you will see that I only went for brown because that's the colors of this month. But also because I thought that there was a little bit too less of color, I added some yellow around the towel a little bit to resemble like the fairies doing magic or something, I don't know, just to give it like an aura. And like the leaves and stuff, I of course colored just in green, and the mushrooms were mostly brown or red. And so these are the main colors also again of the spread, like this orangey yellow, some red, and of course brown. And I think they work very well together. I think it worked out pretty well. And so yeah, you can see me doodle a lot more again. And this time I also included this little froggy sitting on top of this mushroom, because what would be a fairy tale theme without a frog to kiss, right? Now for the second half of this weekly spread, I wanted to add something a little bit more gold again, but also again with mushrooms. So I added this little moon that I did completely in gold, and also some red mushrooms, and I also lettered on top of it. Because at this point I noticed that I didn't have any quote in this weekly spread, which is a pity. I mean, it's a fairy tale themed month, so it needs quotes everywhere. But there's only one, and it's just a little one. It just says, fight for your fairy tale. It's very basic, I know, but I thought it was still fitting because it is the beginning of the month, and so we have a lot more time to go with a lot more fancy quotes. But for the beginning, I think it is all right, and yeah. On this page I also wanted to include another like real-sized fairy, so none of these ugly mini doodles of the fairies. And so I drew another fairy right there, I colored everything in, and on the bottom of the page of course I doodled way more because this page was still too empty. I also added again another mushroom house, a little snail, and some flowers, you know it already. Then, as I was coloring in this page, I thought that my weekly spread didn't have enough color. Yes, I really thought that. And then I also went in with my brown pen again to make my to-do list brown. So this paperish thing, I don't know what it's called, I'm sorry, that looks very old and fitting for the fairy tale theme, I made it brown. I think it looks cute, but it was definitely not as necessary as I thought when I was doing it. So now here we are, these were the spreads for November. I really hoped you like them, and here's this little flip through of the spreads that I made in this video. And yes, that was my whole setup for November, fairy tale themed. I really hope you enjoyed it and liked it, and maybe it brought you some inspiration, or it was just somehow entertaining, I don't know. And so yeah, that's it with this video. I really hope you liked it. I already said that, I'm sorry. And I hope to see you in the next one. So yeah, bye bye.